In this video, we'll discuss the term free fall and some basic concepts about gravity. Free fall refers to the situation when an object is falling toward the ground and is affected only by the gravitational force. In this scenario, we specifically neglect the effects of air resistance. We can include air resistance and other forces in problems we encounter in later chapters after we've learned a few more concepts. So now let's discuss gravity and some key facts we need to know. First, gravity is a force that pulls all objects toward each other. Many people just think of gravity as a force that attracts objects to the Earth or to the Sun or some other large object in space, but it actually acts between any two objects. For instance, a coffee cup and a pen are attracted to each other, and two paper clips are attracted to each other. In these cases, the force is much too small to notice. And that brings us to the next fact. The gravitational force is extremely weak, so we only notice it when at least one of the objects is massive. So that's why we notice it between the Earth and any other object like a pencil or a person. It's because the Earth is so massive. And the last fact is important for our recent work with kinematics. Gravity is a unique force that causes all objects in free fall to have the exact same acceleration, regardless of their masses. Remember, free fall means that the only force acting on an object is gravity. Things change a bit when there are other forces like air resistance. The implication of this statement is that you can drop a bowling ball and a pencil, and if there were no air resistance, then these objects would fall with the exact same acceleration. The value of this acceleration is different near the surface of the Earth versus near the surface of the Moon or Mars or another planet. But the point is that any two objects in free fall near the surface of the Moon will have the same acceleration as each other, or any two objects in free fall near the surface of the Earth will have the same acceleration as each other. Specifically, near the surface of the Earth, all objects in free fall accelerate toward the ground at 9.8 meters per second squared. One thing we should clarify about this statement is what is meant by near the surface of the Earth. The fact is that gravity, and therefore the acceleration due to gravity, becomes weaker the farther the object is from the surface of the Earth. However, the object still has to be quite far from the Earth for its acceleration not to be 9.8 meters per second squared. As a rule of thumb, an object in free fall at, say, the height of an airplane, around 30,000 feet, will have an acceleration of 9.8 meters per second squared. On the other hand, an object that is, say, the distance of a satellite will have a smaller free fall acceleration. So back to an object in free fall near the surface of the Earth. This acceleration value of 9.8 meters per second squared turns out to be quite useful and shows up several times in physics. For that reason, it's assigned the symbol G. All right, so now let's apply this fact to a kinematics problem. Here's an example. A ball is held 1.5 meters above the floor and then dropped. How long will it take for the ball to hit the floor if it is in free fall? Let's follow the kinematics process. First, draw a picture showing the initial and final positions and relative data. And since the ball is in free fall, we know that the acceleration is 9.8 meters per second squared pointing down. By the way, in this problem, it isn't a bad approximation to assume that the ball is in free fall and to neglect air resistance. The speed of the ball is never really large enough over the 1.5 meter drop to generate much air resistance. Okay, so back to the kinematic process. The rest is pretty standard. List the kinematic variables. Notice I've used the traditional coordinate scheme that the positive direction is up, and since the displacement and acceleration point down, I have made them negative. We don't know the final velocity, and we don't need to find it, so I'll mark it out and choose the kinematic equation that does not include the final velocity, which is this one. To simplify the equation a bit, I'll recognize that the initial velocity is zero, and now we can solve algebraically for the time. And then plugging in the values, we get that the time is 0.55 seconds. which seems like a reasonable number if you can imagine dropping a ball from a height of 1.5 meters. So now that brings us to the end of this video. Please also check out the worked out example problem on freefall that is posted on Moodle. That example has some additional elements that are useful to see. Thanks for watching.